up, everybody? It's your boy, Mr. Ghana Baby, once again. And I'm back again with a fresh topic. I've never done this video anywhere in any country before. This is the first time ever. You know what? If I can get 5K likes on this video, I will do it in every country that I go to. You know, I've been telling you guys that Africa is the future. And if Africa is the future, then young Africans are the future of Africa. It's time to ask Africans, I mean young Africans, what will they change in Africa if they are given the chance? It's your boy, Mr. Ghana Baby. Now you can call me the youth president. I am Maya. Stay tuned and enjoy this amazing episode from Freetown, Sierra Leone. My brother, good afternoon.
How are you?
I'm good. Good to see you.
Well, it's a pleasure to meet with you too.
Do you believe that Africa is the future?
Of course, yes.
So if Africa is the future, who are the future of Africa?
Well, the youth.
Africa is the future.
So if Africa is the future, who are the future of Africa?
Well, we are the future. We need to, because we're going to be there for the next generation, the other generation. So we are the future.
Do you believe that Africa is the future?
Oh yes.
Of course, I believe on that and I have the ideology on this. We are the future of Africa.
And if Africa is the future, who are the future of Africa?
The youth.
Do you believe that Africa is the future?
Yes, I do believe so.
So if Africa is the future, then who are the future of Africa?
We, the youth.
Oh yes, yes, I do believe that Africa is the future.
So if you think Africa is the future, who are the future of Africa?
The youths, the young people.
Africa is the future by the way of seeing things.
Thank you so much. So if you get a chance to change something about Africa, what will you change?
Well, I'm a civil engineering student. I believe engineering has a very huge potential. So if we are to have a sustainable developed nation, we must develop our engineering sector. And particularly in Sierra Leone, we must give quality attention to it. And when that one is being done, our economy is going to boom.
Well, I think I'll change the mindset of us, because I'm not going to take myself out of the equation.
Okay.
I think we need to change our mentality. You know, the idea of people thinking that government needs to create jobs, make the opportunities and all of those things, I think that is something blocking or not allowing us to reach where we want to be. Because we all think, okay, I have graduated from university, so the government needs to provide job for me and all that. So if the government does not provide the job, then I'm not going to do anything. So we all relax. So that mentality needs to change. And then the next thing is people need to support upcoming something. You know, here in Sierra Leone, you don't see a lot of that happening. People supporting each other, supporting young ones, like even in the music industry and other industries. Okay. Once you're there, you think you've made it, and so you don't bother to help the one that is coming up. Okay. So I think that's a big problem, because we really have people that have, they are the be all and end alls here. We have them, we have the movers and shakers. It just depends on them helping the ones that are coming up. So I think those are the two things we need to change.
Today, Africans are suffering from mental slavery because after independence, the issue of neo-colonialism is preeminent or still operating or manipulating the minds of Africans. I personally believe if I'm to change Africa, I believe in empowerment. When you empower the youth, you empower the young people, either by formal education or skills.
First of all, my idea is I will just try to think Africans, we have the ability to be self-independent. And if I am asked what will be changed, one, I'm thinking about the mentality, the idea, the way we think towards our development and our resources. These are the things. For example, Africa, we have all what it is, the raw materials, which we have. In fact, these are the things we need to develop. We have the materials. Despite being the technology is not there, but as an African, we have to put ourselves as one. We try to abandon the discrimination sentiment as well. So now, we need to empower the youth.
Thank you.
These are a key factor for African development, empowering the youth. When you empower the youth, you have empowered Africa as well.
If you empower the youth, you've empowered Africa.
The black people always think that the white people are better than us. They take the white people as superior, while the black are inferior.
I will change the mindset. You know, the time I realized that I have started developing as a human being is the time I started changing my thoughts. Most people, most Africans, even a young born son, he could be the first son, and he will have that thought that his or her parents owes him. That is a very, very bad mindset. Nobody owes you. I mean, you should see every offer as just a God-given thing. Nobody owes you. You have to strike by yourself. You have to believe in yourself. You have to go through the hurdles and obstacles so that you can be able to transform.
First of all, party. Family inheritance in line with party has nothing to do with my own perspectives. There are certain people you learn from them that I'm supporting this party because it's based on my family background. My family has been in this party, or there's a certain family relative that has been achieving quite efficiently from a certain party. So immediately they know this party is up for anything, they will just compromise their old thought. First, in a way, they will not even have their own views or perspectives because they are under pressure, they are under family sentiment.
Good.
If I were to do something to change that very aspect, I'll first of all think of less sentiment.
Well, personally, I think there are a lot of things. I think the problem in Africa is just so big. And one of those things that I think that we should pay attention to, I can change, if I may, is the system. I mean, there are a lot of things in the system that is wrong, that does not help the youth, the young people to grow, particularly the system of education in Africa. I think that for a very long while, with all the systems of colonialism, what they gave to us in education, I think it's not helping us as a continent. Mm. And so I think if we can be able to change that, then we can put ourselves properly, on the trajectory to go, so that the youths can really, get to the point in which they can move the continent to the future that we deserve.
One thing we need to change in Africa is the perception of dishonesty. Africa, we are dishonest. Even our leaders are dishonest. They are not honest to us. They have covered us with dishonest canopy. They are ruling us badly. In Africa, they have taken politics as something to come and enrich themselves, but forgetting that they have subjects, they have people who they are here to serve. How can you be president and you are focusing on building empire, forgetting about the subjects? That's bad, that's dishonesty.
What is the major challenge that you face as a young African in Sierra Leone?
Well, motivation is a very big problem. We don't have that kind of enabling environment wherein young people are motivated to see how best we can contribute towards our nation building, because some of us, we have the interest, we have the passion, we have the energy, but the encouragement is not that too encouraging. So if there is anything that we want our leaders to fix, they should start from there, encourage young people to participate in developmental processes.
Thank you so much. And what is your name?
Well, my name is Abdullahi Amara, a civil engineering student at Fabe College, University of Sierra Leone.
Thank you.
We don't have support from people that are already there. And then we think the government is supposed to create opportunities for us, so we don't go out there and search for opportunities. And another challenge is that we already know, some of us, we've thought about opportunities, we have business ideas, but then you need the platform. Wow. You don't just get up one morning and say, I want to be an entrepreneur. What are you selling? Who is going to buy? So you need the platform before succeeding in what you have already. So I think we need the platform.
Well, the challenges are many. It depends on the regional area you belong, because here as a youth, we don't have the industry, for example, the technical folk. Because whenever you want to empower our youth, you need the skills. Youth have to be independent on their own, to learn something that will make him to be a better person in the future.
You know, in Africa, you can have your degree, but to find a job is very, very difficult. It's not easy.
So you mean you have the qualified degree, but you don't get a job?
Yeah.
Well, we all have different challenges, but I do believe that's the one that is quite common, because everywhere you go now, you hear youths crying about they have not been given the equal footing or the opportunity that one requires to grow and develop fully into a responsible human being. So I think Africa lacks the opportunity. Well, most of the time the youths tend to challenge to the politicians because, most of us think that they should provide all the necessary resources. Nevertheless, there are great amounts of youth that has nothing to offer, like you thinking of having skill sets, having the right degree or so. Well, in that case, one cannot just place thoughts on that, considering the fact that we have also students and other professionals that have the skills and have the knowledge, yet they are unemployed. Yeah. So it's quite hard to just take sides on issues like that. Yeah. But I believe Africa has the resources, we have the human capacity, we have the knowledge and everything. It's just maybe the corruptive practices, as one may say. But I believe Africa is the future, if only we can work collaboratively.
Well, a lot of things, you know, unemployment, lack of opportunities to deliver, and all of those things, like I said, all goes back to the system. You know, if leaders, political leaders, who are given the responsibility by the people themselves to manage their affairs, create the opportunities, you know, by way of providing the source or youthful employment or just change everything that will see that youth grow, then I think it should be okay. But if as long as the opportunities are not there, the opportunities are not provided, then I don't see it. You know, a youth, for example, can have a brilliant idea, you know, can be an innovator, but the platform is not there to exhibit what you can give. So then the future will have a problem.